Kleinschmidt. What a play by DePaul.
I've been on many teams here in my last 4 years with DePaul, and I thought by far they was the best team chemistry-wise with guys hanging out with one another.
Kleinschmidt behind the back to Hill, to Davis for the layup.
We played together as a team, and we had that team togetherness, and we had that cohesiveness among each other that, you know, that we were all for one and one for all.
Good move by Kleinschmidt. Chris Hill. Comes off, stolen by Patton, to Kleinschmidt, and count it. What a tremendous play by Patton.
All the players were a close knit family, so to speak. You know, we all got along pretty much with each other. You know, we were willing to help each other, not only on the court, but off the court as well.
Cole Kleinschmidt, nice fake. Got it.
He has really got a good stroke, and he's playing with such a. I'd get a TO if I was Calipari. There it is.
When you can get an entire team believing in each other and playing hard and playing together, then, you know, you can't. That's going to put you in the running to win any game against anybody.
Stand by for action.
He comes out there, he's pumping iron every day, and he goes out there and tries to break the backboard every time he slam dunks the ball.
Ramsey with the answer inside.
Ramsey's a militant leader of our team. He's a sergeant. Some other guys are always in good mood, seems he's always in a bad mood.
The big man Willis slapped out by Ramsey. Ramsey the block. Rejected by Ramsey again.
Might show a little bit of an outside shot this year. That's probably scared everybody.
Ramsey from way out of his range. Whoa! My goodness.
He's a scary guy. I mean, if you walk down the alley, you wouldn't want to fake Mike Ramsey. I mean, I live with him. I don't like facing that much.
Touch. Cole for three. He's got it at the buzzer.
He's 6 foot barely. You can 6 foot barely. He's about a buck 25, and the guy, you know, for a while there, you know, he was just carrying us a little bit on his, and he's carrying us on his shoulders.
Ball is Cole punked it away and then drops it in.
He's a hustler. He's like that off the court and on the court. You know, he's always looking for a deal, looking for that thing to do, and you know, he brings that on the court. He's always looking for a call or something like that.
He'll tell you how bad you are and you can't do this, but he'll dunk on you any chance he gets. Don't mess with him because he's the best in the world.
I think he feels it.
He's really quick, and he isn't that big, but he plays big. He has a lot of heart, and he'll go down and mix it up with the big guys and all, and he's a tremendous player.
Inside, Brian Bowden layup is good. Beautiful.
That's probably the best touch that I've seen for a big man, because I don't have it and he has it.
He's thinking about another one. Yeah.
He's like a big bear. He's always smiling, but he'll just throw you, and he don't care. You know, he hits you and elbow you, just push you around and cheat, do whatever it takes.
I've guarded a lot of guys, but none. I mean, Bo is just huge. When Bo sits and plants, you know, you can't stop him. I'm gonna be honest with you. It's really hard to stop him.
Bowden gets the layup for DePaul. DePaul has 10 seconds left. Down by two.
Me, Brian Kerr, and Jermaine Galloway, and we all sitting beside each other. I was like, Brian, Brandon gonna hit the winning shot for this game.
He came over to me, and I said, you know, Brandon, just, you know, keep shooting, man. He's like, man, I'm gonna win the game for us.
I just had that feeling that I was gonna hit that shot, and I told the players before it was a timeout, before we went back on the court, I said, watch, I'm gonna hit this shot.
I inbounded it, and I was looking for it back, but I knew Brandon was gonna put it up.
Brandon kind of looked at me like he was gonna pass to me, and he said, no, I'm not gonna give it to you.
Penetrate, three-pointer,
got it! DePaul leads by one!
When it went in, I mean, I'm sitting there like, man, this ain't supposed to happen, you know, in person. This is something you see on TV.
You look at games like that on TV, and to be a part of it, you know, because that was a game we were supposed to win, and a win like that was unbelievable, you know, because we had played terribly.
TK, well, that's kind of self-explanatory.
Kleinschmidt again! Are you seeing a PTP performer, a primetime performer?
He gets real upset, you know, when we lose and stuff, because, you know, he likes to do anything he can to prevent losing.
Kleinschmidt blocked it and saved it.
He's a fighter, he hates to lose, and he gives you a lot of inspiration because of his, you know, his attitude.
The basket right there. Well, he comes up with it, and Kleinschmidt's fired up, and he's got the crowd on their feet as he scores and draws the foul.
He's a leader out on the court. And last year, you know, he came through in a lot of situations where if me and Terry were not hitting our shot, you know, he was, you know, he would always come through some kind of way.
Kleinschmidt with a rebound, put it in.
He just goes out there and he goes out there to win. He's got to score 50 to win or he's got to score 0 to win. He just wants to win.
I've played against a lot of guys, but I've never seen a guy who plays as hard and who wants to win like Tom Kleinschmidt.
When we play like pickup games and even in practice and all, and he makes those unbelievable shots that, you know, you can only slink in if you were the plastic man or whatever.
Murray up for the shot and in.
He's got a real, real nice shot. And just, I mean, you can't leave him alone for a second because they'll drill it.
Murray also in as Murray lays it in.
A lot of people look at him and be like, this guy's running two guards, but Malik will make you, he will drive you in a minute and probably knock you over. He'll probably run over you doing it.
For three, it just will not fall from out there, but Hill with the rebound and the left-handed layup.
He jumped about that high off the floor, so, you know, I don't understand how he get those rebounds, but somehow he goes out there, he get the job done.
And it's good. He'll head for the line.
He can't jump worth a lick, but he seems to get all the rebounds. He knows how to use his body really well.
Air ball, kill the follow, got it. He'll head for the strike.
He gives it all the time. He just, you know, you can tell he's a winner. He's a fighter, and he really works to improve.
We made them both. DePaul needs a 3 to tie. Peter Patton, he shot it. It's off the back iron, no good. Kleinschmidt. Good!
I knew there was about 5 seconds left on the clock, so just try to get in a rebound and try to get out the 3-point arc as soon as I could, and I kind of just flinged it up there and, you know, got in for my prayer, went in.
Everybody had pretty much just said, hey, well, you know, that's the end of the game, DePaul lost. You know, but Tom put the shot up, and from the corner, it looked good. But I was like, oh, this is going to be long. And it hit, and I was like, goodness.
We seen it going in from the bench, and I was like, oh, my goodness. It just went in, and we just went crazy.
It was like college basketball at its best. It was just unbelievable. It's just a feeling you just can't describe. You just have to be on the court, and Tom's got you going. It's like you have a new life.
Getting a little more aggressive. Oh, and count it! What a tremendous one-on-one play!
Brian Curry is by far the funniest person I've ever met in my life. You know, he always has me laughing.
Curry's the comedian of the team. You know, you'll be just about telling him to shut up, and he'll say something that's hilarious. You just gotta laugh. You know?
Curry's got it in the lane, and he scores again.
Great athlete. I think in years to come, he's gonna be one of the best players that ever came to the DePaul. I mean, he can jump out the gym.
I love watching some of the dunks that he does and some of the athletic plays that he makes. I think he can be turn into a real star here at DePaul. He was a choir leader on the bench as far as being in threes and keeping the team members in the game. And, you know, we also need that type of leadership from the bench sometimes to help teams carry over.
Galloway, soft little shot.
He pushed the big players every day in practice. He pushed us in practice. You know, he's an integral part of our team.
He has a real soft touch around the basket. You know, he works real hard to practice. You know, he gives me everything I got. You know, he pushes you to the limit and everything. He's just nice competitor. He's a real good kid, and I like him a lot. Pete is unbelievable. I mean, I've never seen a kid hustle like Pete before.
Pick it up, please.
Patton again.
Patient. Patton right over the Cincinnati radio broadcast.
Pete would rather dive into a metal post and crack his head open instead of letting the ball roll out.
Patton for three. Got it!
He's always working hard. He comes, dives on the floor, does all little things. He's the kind of guy that you don't want to guard you. He's always all over you.
They step through after the pump fake by Patton.
I'd say he's really a player coach. He really is, because he cares about his players first.
Over the years, I think we established a friendship that will last for quite a while, because I don't think I'll ever forget about him, because he has done so much for me here at DePaul.
He has a great love for all his players, and he'll do anything he can to help us out at any time.
He wants what's best for you and what's best for the program at DePaul. And,
know, I'm glad he's my coach.
I love playing with Terry. He works hard all the time. He's not a person that complains if you don't get the ball. I mean, we can come down 5-6 times and he might not touch the ball at all. And, you know, he wouldn't have a problem at all with that.
Davis off the bounce. Davis score!
He's a great player. Terry just was, I mean, out there working hard every day, was a great floor leader, great leader by example.
Tries to get it. Does. Goes right to the basket. And there's 1,400 points for Terry Davis.
He's always been there for me and all of the players. I think all of them can say that. And I think Terry's a great athlete. You know, he has a, he like to be a bodybuilder. You know, I'm not going to tell him that because his hair gets big.
From the left wing, Davis, and that's a three.
You know, I just want people to kind of think of me as, you know, a hard-working type of guy, the guy that just left everything he had out on the floor each and every night that he went out to play.
Price from the paint and the foul.
He provides that emotion and that intensity that a lot of guys don't have. He's more of the spiritual and more of the intensifier on the team, the guy that gets everybody going.
16 footer right through. Oh my goodness.
Just being at DePaul was like a great experience because everywhere I went, people knew me. You know, it's like DePaul basketball is so big. It's like you travel to California, you got people coming to our games, you got stars coming to our games to kind of watch us play.
Yeah.